Welcome back, Nick and Lex here. Thank you so much for joining me to another episode of Music with Nick. So today we got another request, and today we're gonna do we will do Starcastle for Greybeard, and let's see, Starcastle, we're gonna do the song Fountains, and this is from Fountains of Light. Now I've no idea what kind of music this is, but I'm sure it's good. Just by the cover, the year 1977, and it's Eric. I know this is going to be good. So thank you so much, Eric, for sponsoring the video for everyone, and making this video happen. These are probably the last songs I'll do on the channel. Like, when it comes to songs, I'll do them with Alexia, because songs are so much shorter. They're easier to do. It's just not so much sitting, so I'll take over the marathons, and then if Alexia can do a marathon once in a while, we'll do that. I think that's it's just a better system. So these are like the last songs. I'm kind of sad because it is kind of fun to just do a song and then, you know, get up and leave. But yeah, so it's just because of Alexia, you know. Alexia's back, it's not getting better, and it's just getting harder to make videos. So if I can do something with her that's shorter, then we should change. So, all right, so thank you so much, Eric, for this request. Starcastle, I've never heard of them. Let's see what they got. This is the longest song. This is the album opener on the album. Fountains. 10 minutes and 21 seconds. And so let's get into it. All right. Thank you so much, Eric. And also everyone who's new to the channel. If you're a fan of Starcastle or you stumbled across the channel, make sure to leave a like, or if you want to subscribe or whatever, all that good stuff. All right. Here we go.
Thank you.
Very good. Starcastle. So they're an American progressive rock band from Illinois. Wow. Really good. Like, they literally reminded me of, like, Rush at the beginning, the whole instrumentation, and then the singer. It reminds me a little bit of John Anderson. I don't know if you can hear it, but John Anderson and Chris Squire together, you know, those harmonies they do? Really cool. I'm loving it. This is awesome. Thank you. Thank you, Greybeard. This is good stuff. A lot of people will like this. Starcastle. And they also used to call themselves Pegasus and Mad John Fever. I'm sure you guys are just, like, so knowledgeable, but well, if you didn't know it, now you know. So, all right. So thank you. This is great. This is good stuff.
Thank you.
Jesus. Wow. So I mean, they definitely remind me of Yes, like very, very much. I never took off the glasses because I'm listening to Prague. I'm just joking. It's just like, I just realized by keeping the glasses on, I can, if I navigate around here, you know, it's so I don't have to flinch. I don't know. Maybe I'm just going to get like, you know, those contact lenses. Although we have a doctor in the family, specifically an eye doctor. So I don't know if he's going to see this, but hey, come on, man. Help a brother out. You know, no, I'm probably going to get surgery and then I can stop, you know, talking about it, because it just sucks, you know, when you have like perfect vision and then one day it's just like gone. But it's because I had an accident. I had an accident in this with this eye. I had a very bad infection in Mexico that lasted months and months. I had to wear like an eye patch. And so this eye took a lot of strain from that. And then I had these recurring infections that would come back. And then this last time when I here in the States, and I would always take like this Mexican medicine. And you know, when you go to Mexico, you get like medicine that actually works. You take one pill and you're like good. You're like healed. And here it's like I was taking pills and pills for weeks. It would not get better, the infection. It would just not, until I made a phone call. Hey, please send me these pills. And it was a cream, I think. Put in the cream one time, infection. But that time, this eye took so much strain because it had to take over that I lost my eyesight. So yeah, so, I mean, do whatever you want, you know, take the medicine where it's best. I'm not, like, advocating buying medicine in Mexico. But back to the song, this was definitely a prog fest. Love the keyboards. The bass sounded very, like, Chris Squire inspired. Also the singing, you know, along with John Anderson. But, I mean, it's a totally different band, but I just feel that from the prog that I know, like maybe Genesis or Kansas or Floyd or, you know, Rush, the one I could, even ELP, the one I could pin it down to the closest would be, it sounded a lot like Yes. I'm sure they had maybe like an influence or were inspired by, but really, but holding themselves on their own amazingly well. I mean, I would totally listen to more Starcastle. Like right away, they really did a great job, and the whole thing was very entertaining, very busy, very just the way I love it. A lot of stuff. I don't think there was any guitar solos, but there was a lot of interplay between just the singing and the piano and the bass and the drums. Very cool drumming too. So really, really cool. Thank you, Eric, for this new band, because all the other stuff that I'm going to do right now, I'm pretty much familiar. Even though, no, I'm going to do Carrot. So I have not. I'm sure this is something from Germany because it's for Narvik. And also the album title is in Germany. Über sieben Brücken. That's what we're going to do next. So, but thank you so much, Eric, for this. This was awesome. Thank you for the request. I loved it. I hope everybody enjoyed. Let me know what you think of this band in the comment section. Let's give it a lot of likes, you know. I see that a lot of reactions that I do by myself have like not even like half the views they have when we do them together. I mean, I do understand Alexia is very essential, but yeah, just like, you know, I get it. So as long as you know the people that I know who you guys are, as long as you guys are happy and watch the channel while I'm by myself, that's cool, you know. All right, so, well, you have a wonderful day, and thank you for being here. See you in the next one.